Knights of the Old Republic, or KOTOR as it's often known, needs no introduction. It continues to be one of the most celebrated RPGs of all time. The game came out back in, 2003, and looking at Metacritic, you can see it has one of the highest scores in the PC platform, one of the highest user scores on PC. Same with Xbox. The reviews and ratings are even higher on the original Xbox. Suffice to say, this is a seminal game that defined RPGs of that time and set the groundwork for future RPGs to come. It is the gold standard in a lot of ways. And many, of course, are wondering, when are they going to remake this game? If there's one game that's due for a remake, it is Knights of the Old Republic, with its very solid and awesome foundation. You know, imagine seeing all of that modernized with modern graphics and modern gameplay sensibilities. You know, I think it could turn out to be something amazing if the right developers and studios helm it. Now, there are plenty of rumors out there that a remake is in the works, and those rumors seem to be heating up with every passing year. And the latest story surrounding the game's development, the reported development of the title, is that it is happening, but not by who you'd expect it to come from. The following information was reported by news outlet Game Informer from editor Liana Rupert. The headline reads, "New Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic game reportedly in the works without BioWare." This is significant, of course, because BioWare is the original developer of the original Knights of the Old Republic. So the article continues, "The latest report comes by the way of VGC from reputable Star Wars insider Bespin Bulletin. During a recent Bob the Podcast episode, the discussion of a mysterious project came up, a project that Bespin alleges is a brand new Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic game. They added that fans will never guess who is helming the rumored task." What this quote suggests to me is that whoever is helming this project isn't going to be someone obvious, so obviously people are immediately going to think of Obsidian because they helmed the sequel to Knights of the Old Republic. But the fact that fans will never guess, according to the report, suggests to me that's probably not going to be the studio. It's going to be someone that hopefully will be reputable, but as far as EA and BioWare go, they're completely not involved in the project, according to reports. And here's a quote to that effect stating, "Amongst my digging, I heard there's a Knights of the Old Republic project in development somewhere. I talked to a couple of people, and I also found out that Jason Schreier said that it's not with EA, and will never guess who the studio is that's making this game." Indeed, if you look at tweets from back in February of 2020, Jason Schreier published the following article. There was apparently supposed to be some kind of Star Wars Battlefront spinoff that was canceled last year, or the year prior to this article, rather. And at one point, somebody asked, "So no remaster for Old Republic?" Jason responded, "Let me get back to you on that one." And then another response reads, "You're such a tease sometimes." To which Jason responded, "Sorry, I just don't like to share things unless I'm 100% sure about them, and I'm still doing some reporting on the KOTOR rumor. I'll say this though, if it's really happening, it's not at EA." So it would seem as though Jason Schreier knew something at the time. It was just a matter of confirming the information that he received, but it looks like even he heard at some point that KOTOR is being remade, and that if it's being remade, and assuming what the sources are saying are true, it won't be EA who's publishing it, it won't be BioWare who is developing it. Which, you know, on one hand, I understand that BioWare was the original developer, and it's strange that KOTOR would go to somebody else. But on the other hand, keep in mind that the BioWare that made Knights of the Old Republic is not the BioWare of now. So many developers have left. The studio itself is very different from what it used to be, especially with EA's, you know, seeping influence, among other things. But mainly, the talent at the studio, you know, it's very different now from what it was years and years ago. Even Casey Hudson and Mark Dara have left at this point. So for me, and given BioWare's past history with the launch of Anthem and Mass Effect Andromeda, maybe it's a good thing that a KOTOR remake will be happening through fresh eyes, through a studio that, again, is hopefully reputable. Though until I know exactly which studio and publisher are helming the remake of KOTOR, it's hard for me to say whether this is going to be a good or bad situation, but I'm certainly hoping for the best. And generally, I don't mind that EA isn't publishing this game. I don't know what shenanigans that pull trying to add some microtransactions to a game like this. And BioWare as developers, they've, you know, kind of lost my trust over the years. So them not helming this project, especially given it's not the same studio that it was, not a big deal to me either. Going back to the Game Informer article, it is noted that this isn't the first time these rumors have come up, which is indeed true. And it is also highlighted that at the time, however, my source did not state that EA was distanced from this project, a project that has been rumored several times over to be a complete remake. So back in 2020, Liana had also heard rumors about this project, but she had not been told that EA wouldn't be at the helm of this, but Jason Schreier seemingly got that information back in February 2020, and now we're hearing rumors of that once again. And normally when different outlets who have different sources start looking into something and their information starts lining up, it tends to mean there's something there. It tends to mean that, you know, it's something worth keeping your eyes peeled for. And you can imagine why such rumors that EA would not be helming the next KOTOR would raise some eyebrows, given that the EA Star Wars publishing exclusivity deal was still in effect. But it was only recently that Lucasfilm announced that Star Wars would no longer be exclusive to EA. Other publishers and developers will be partnering with Disney in order to bring to life Star Wars titles. Now the floodgates have been open, and now other developers can indeed tackle their own vision of Star Wars, and it would seem as though this is another way that that's happening through this KOTOR remake. And I guess even in 2020, you know, there were talks of the Disney EA Star Wars exclusivity deal potentially ending, but we only recently got confirmation, and now everything else makes sense. And we've seen, you know, already Ubisoft announce their own Star Wars entry from the developers of the Division series, which I don't know how that will go. But the fact that other developers can tackle Star Wars now is, I think, ultimately a very good thing. Just really will add a lot of variety to Star Wars games as a whole. And KOTOR, through fresh eyes, not published by EA, not developed by BioWare, I think could be a very good thing if handled correctly. Finally, the article reports on previous rumors and what they report the purpose of the remake is, which is that it'll blend elements from Knights of the Old Republic and Knights of the Old Republic 2, The Sith Lords. The reworking will blend the two stories in a way that makes sense with the current Star Wars canon. Yeah, don't expect this remake to be an exact replica of the old video game. No doubt there are going to be some narrative changes to accommodate for the new canon, and no doubt they're going to try to tie everything together. But I hope that there are enough narrative and gameplay elements from the old game to make it feel as though this is a remake of that title, instead of just a completely different game that just has the label of Knights of the Old Republic. They have to find a good balance of new and old. They need to have some of the moments from the old game that really captivated us, while also evolving the gameplay and obviously the graphics and the narrative if they have to, as long as, you know, they don't botch it. But yeah, beyond the game happening, the big story really is that EA and BioWare are not involved with this project at all, given their past relationship to the Star Wars franchise and the KOTOR franchise. I mean, EA is the publisher of Star Wars The Old Republic, the MMO, but, you know, with Knights of the Old Republic, it would seem as though they're not going to come anywhere close to that. And I'm okay with that, personally. Though, whether this is all ultimately a remake worth looking forward to or not, we will largely depend on the eventual announcement of who is ultimately helming this project and which publisher is funding it, as I think that will greatly inform what kind of game we can expect and what kind of business model we can expect, if there's anything shady that's going to go on. And, you know, it'll speak to the quality of the game as well. So until that's confirmed, I'm going to be a little cautious about my optimism, but the prospect of a KOTOR remake is an enticing and exciting one, and this is the latest on all of that, and I hope this proved to be informational to you guys. In the meantime, as we await further information, let me know in the comments below what your thoughts and opinions are on the prospects of a KOTOR remake, and what you think about EA and BioWare not being involved. drop a comment, and to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.